I can't do this all on my own. No, I'm no Superman.
Hey, Scrubs. If you'd like to skip this message, we have timestamps and labels for each match in the description below. Now, I'd like to start out by thanking all of my new Scrubscribers as well as my old Scrubscribers. We've tripled our scrub count in the last 28 days, and for that, I'm really thankful and happy that you guys are enjoying the content. I could post another image showing how about 70% of you that are watching my videos aren't actually subscribed, but it seems like that's just what everyone does and seems a little redundant to me. But if you do find yourself enjoying the content, consider joining our community. And if I turn out to be a huge doucher, you can always unscrubscribe later. So what have you got to lose? Just go ahead and click that subscribe button. Just go ahead and be a scrub just like me.
Do it.
Do it!
Do it.
Just do it!
Do it.
Just do it!
Do it.
Well, now that that's over, I hope you enjoy the video.
Scrubs, we are back at it again with those elemental thick boys. We definitely changed up the sideboard quite a bit. Shaper Sanctuary has been pretty good. It's helping us not get outvalued by the control decks. Only time they really get us is when they have a sweeper effect. But overall, it's been pretty good. We have Surgical Extraction because we've been playing a lot of combo decks recently. We also are playing 3 Damping Spheres now, just as a means to help us in the Storm matchup. We've been seeing a lot of Amulet Titan as well as a lot of Tron. So just trying to shore up those matches a little bit. Just trying to hit what we've been playing the most. So we're definitely playing, like, before we were playing like a bunch of 1 and 2 ofs normally. I guess at one point we were playing 4 black ley lines, 4 white ley lines. It kind of just felt like a lot of sideboard slots for hitting maybe just a handful of decks, like maybe 4 or 5 different decks. And there's just so many different decks you play against in Modern. But we're just kind of focusing on combo, focusing on control with spot removal as well as prowess decks. Damping Sphere for the Storm combo as well as the Eldrazi Tron and Titan, Amulet Titan matchups. So we're going to give it a shot. We have been running in a little bit of a dry spell as far as success goes with our Elementals decks. Both decks, for that matter, not our Thick Boys, as well as what we call our competitive build. But at the moment, I'm kind of liking the Thick Boys a little better. Just like doing bigger, better stuff, you know? We wound up cutting the fan images from our Thick Boys deck. Our Thick Boys deck isn't playing Aether Vial, where our competitive list is playing Aether Vial. Because in our Thick Boys deck, we're playing 4 birds and 2 Noble Hierarch. And we found that fan image is best when we're vialing it in to copy our Risen Reef turn 3 after vials on 2, or copy our Skelemental on 3 when our vials on 2. And it's just, you know, now if we have like a Mana Dork out turn 3, where, you know, we have 4 lands, we can't play our 3 drop as well as copy it. We can play the 3 drops on 2 if we get a Mana Dork out turn 1, but it just doesn't always work out that way. Then at that point, like, cause like a lot of times on turn 3 they're tapping out to do something, you know, so if we can land our 3 as well as copy it in the same turn while they're tapped out, we can keep that value. Now if we're playing our Risen Reef on turn 2, they're getting ready to remove it in response to whatever we play, and if we play our Phantasmal image trying to copy our Risen Reef now, well, then they'll just blow up the Risen Reef and we've lost value, because now we're copying our birds, and it just, having extra birds is how this deck dies quickly. You know, you need gas. So we've gassed ourselves up a little bit more by taking out the fan image, I think. And also, I think we were running into a lot of hands where we were mulliganing because we had a bunch of birds and a fan image and like a smoke breather, and then we just have a hand that doesn't do anything. Just gonna turn this music down just a little bit. There we go. Just to put it in the background a little more. Yes, we would like to go first. Thank you. While opponent tanks. All right. This hand does stuff. For her birthday, I got her a hydroponic growing kit, so she's growing herbs, and we're talking the good herbs, not the devil's lettuce. Not that that's not a good herb. But she's growing like thyme and basil and stuff, and she likes to grow things, although she's not terribly good at it, and this device allows her to kind of set it and forget it. It has its own cycle. It'll tell you when it needs to be refilled with water, and it has its own light cycle. Like, I think it's just 12 hours on, 12 hours off. Unfortunately, she has it cycling so that it's on throughout the whole night. So there's, when I'm back in my bedroom, I can see this illuminating light from out in our kitchen area. Oh. This deck, and we want a Thunderkin, something fierce. No, we actually just want to make maximize our mana. Lexa better start listening. Okay. This, what is this? Ocha by Harris Heller. A-O-C-H-A by Harris Heller. Like that kind of Japanese flair. Maybe it's Chinese, I don't know. I'm not very... I haven't apprised myself of... Okay, not even close. Finally lets me fetch. Well, we definitely need some help. We're not in the best of shape. We need some more threats. I think if I'm not drawing anything and I play Fulminator, I don't think I'm cracking it unless he misses his land drop here. I think I just need to start attacking. Thank you. I've never lost to this deck, so I hope this isn't the first time that we actually do lose to this deck. Famous last words, never lost. Are you gonna tank again? Oh, drown in the lock? Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, I mean, it's not great, it's fine. At least he has a lot of non-mill spells. We're kind of sandbagging our Ziggurat to maybe make him pop his Field of Ruin, thinking that we might get stumbled on colored mana.
Sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. Crispy. Juicy. And tender.
Okay.
It's crispy, juicy, tender. All one word. But then, also pickle. Oh,
not the artifact. Please not the artifact.
Okay, we can't sum up our new crispy chicken sandwich.
Okay, so we still got 26 cards left. Okay, that's a card. We like to see our Lord. Lords do stuff. He has one card in hand. Now he's gonna tank before blocks while he's tapped out. Oh, Lurrus, sure. Man, now with Lurrus in the graveyard. I mean, with Lurrus in his grip, I don't necessarily... Oh, sweet. Well, that probably does it. I think we bring this in for the artifact that he may or may not have. I don't know about this. I guess it because he has Fatal Push, he has Drown in the Lock. Because we are going to have Cavernous Souls, so maybe he'll Drown in the Lock and we'll get some triggers. We can trim on that guy. Definitely trim on this. We can trim on our do-less duders, I guess. We definitely want gas. Hmm. think we can afford to be a little slower. We really want to cast Shaper Sanctuary on one anyway, right? So we're going to be slower anyway. His hand's okay. I think I'm ditching this, though. Oh, I had to ditch two cards? Fuck. Begrudgingly. Definitely need lands. Here's. We upped the land at 22, and we kept on getting one land hands. And at 21, we were getting flooded. Yeah. Alright, give me another land. Oh no, I don't need another land. What am I talking about? What am I, stupid? Am I stupid or something? Oh. Oops. No surgical plays. Maybe I should have just pitched that just because I know that's a surgical target. Here he goes. Yep. If he doesn't have black, but I guess he just played his tapped land. Probably has black. Yep. So we could be in trouble. Another Thunderkin would be awesome. For it. Potentially problematic. Nice one for one. I don't know why that card's still in his deck. That card is so bad. This card is so bad. Yeah, mark that down as a card we don't give a fuck about. Just fucking tap out to make myself mill. Oh, that's unfortunate. Well, he already saw my deck, so no reason not to play it out, I guess, but we're definitely in rough shape here. Oh, Ingachur also got exiled. So our only way to win now is Omnath. That is an Omnath.
We can sum up McDonald's new crispy chicken sandwich in one word. Crispy. But also juicy. And tender. Okay, it's crispy, juicy, tender. All one word. But then, also pickle. Oh, and potato bun, which is two words. Okay, we can't sum up our new crispy chicken sandwich in one word, so you'll just have to try it to understand it. Order ahead on the McDonald's app.
Yeah, I don't think we can do it, boys. But I'll definitely help wind down his clock. So I just need to stop tapping out and I just gotta make him kill me. Cards is a lot. That puts us down to 3, and then fetch lane gets us. I guess he screenshotted our deck. No? I don't know what he did. Weird. I mean, we can play that, but it's not gonna do anything, so... didn't get the cigarette from our deck to kill us last turn. Yeah, keep tanking. Okay. Yes, up. Well, we got a curve all the way to 4. Oh, he's put Luris in his deck. I guess because of sideboard cards. Must be because of his sideboard cards. Keep tanking, buddy. This should be a good one, I would think. Every time. Didn't wait for my draw step this time. Only one Thunderkin left. There goes Ingachur. All right. We'll take it. Still have not lost to that mill deck. Although I wasn't completely comfortable with that last game. Oh, actually, I need to go run and get my girlfriend's laundry real quick. And by girlfriend, I mean fiance. Don't let her know that I say girlfriend. Should have left the deck up while I was out and about. We love it. We love our elementals. That's for sure. Oh, yes, 8 undefeated trophies. I wonder if that's all with Burn. We'll keep this. We have turn 2 Fulminator Mage or turn 2 Shriek Maw plus Bolt. We can't turn 2 Skelemental, unfortunately. Hierarch does not allow for that. That's a cool looking amulet. Birds, you say? I just might may. I just might may.
There's a message for that in a playlist too, because every bag comes with a scannable Spotify code. So
let's turn it up, just not too loud.
Tap to listen.
I spec'd on Dryad of the Elysian Grove pretty hard. I think I bought 3 playsets. Which isn't that hard. I think I bought them for like $5 a piece. I think they're worth more than that now. Probably at least 8. So not like great return, but... Fuck you, man. I fucking hate this deck. I really hate this deck. I can nug 2 out of the cards out of his hand, though. So, he either have to leave the Titan and hit a Kuru land or whatever they're called, I forget. I forget, sis. Or he leaves the, I think they're called Kuru lands in his hand and hope to hit the Titan or the Summoner's Pact. But it's definitely hold the land, I think. I don't know. You have 8 chances to hit Pact or Titan. I don't know how many you have to hit. I don't know how many Kuru lands they run. Not while he tanks. So he pitches Ghoul Turf, Summoner's Pact. But like, even if I Fulminator Mage his land, if he hits another one of those lands, it's basically like, yeah, especially with three. Holy fuck. Alright, cool. Well, now I know we're good. Now I know we're good. Another summoner's pact, okay. Alright, now I'm just gonna cast this guy because we'll have him dead next turn. We win. Keeping the Temur Omnath in goes over the head a little bit. The +1/+1 counters can be put on Thunderkins to get back Fulminator Mages. Even that in the past has proven not to be enough. We Fulminator Mage two Guru lands and another land, and even with pressure, he's still comboing off because with two or three Aether Vials. With two Aether Vials and, like, a Dryad of the Elysian Grove, he can add 8 mana. It's just insane. It's insane. This hand would be great if we had a red source. We have quite a few red sources in the main. The only... I don't know. I think I'm going to keep this hand. This is, like, if we have to play the Cavern on birds, so be it. we're probably going to be fulminating. We're going to be fulminator maging turn two anyway. Hopefully we can draw into the land by then. Then we can skelly, thunderkin, skelly. Or we just draw the green source right off the top. That would be even better. We love to see tap land. He can't amulet turn one. I think I'm just gonna do this. He doesn't have any amulets. Oh, I can't do that shit. Can't do that. I guess I'm just doing this. He's just stream sniping and knew not to play the Karui land yet. I wish that the Exalt trigger with Thunderkin made it so that we could recur twos. Unfortunately, it doesn't, but man, that would be sweet if it did. Dryad is so good. Super, super good. About to be killed by amuletless amulet. Definitely betrayed us, that's for sure. at any land. New our board. Gets four triggers. Copy Valakut. Yeah, that's good enough. Stuff against this deck. We need to stop hitting lands, please.
Let him say it for you with Eminem's messages. Whether you want to tell a friend to
Slay Girl
or extend an olive branch.
We all make mistakes. I just make more of them.
There's a message for that in a playlist, too. Because every bag comes with a scannable Spotify code. So
let's turn it up. Just not too loud.
Tap to listen.
Why are you tanking? Hey, what's up, man? How you doing? Sure, man. Just followed you. Accidentally canceled out my music, but... Thanks, bud. Appreciate that. Superman. Is it just magic? Are you playing anything else? Yeah, no problem, man. Yeah, man, appreciate you. Thanks for stopping in. Man, opponent has just pumped the brakes. He's just playing so slow. It almost makes me feel like he's trying to stream snipe or something. I don't know. Let me start my music back up. Rocket League, COD, and some others. Nice. Sweet. That was a good draw. Oops. All right, now let's not tap like a dummy. Probably should have sandbagged that for when I play Omnath next turn. That land. I guess he can tap that for one of any color. But if he tries to tap it for two, it just produces a colorless. And I need more water. Even though we can't kill his dryad, we still cast this. Blue, green, white. Yeah, hey.
Oh, yeah, hello, where are you at?
Home.
Oh.
Where are you?
That's like you're out in the street.
No.
Oh.
I'm streaming.
Nice.
Yeah, what are you up to?
On my home.
Already?
It's 10:30.
I know, I just figured you'd be out later.
I got a lot to tell
you. You got a lot to tell me?
Yeah, who are you streaming with?
Just me.
Oh, you don't got no bird?
No, didn't invite anyone on just because the deck hasn't been doing really well, but so far we're doing alright.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Also, I started kind of late. I'm only through two. Well, this is only the second match. Hey.
Long.
Yeah.
How long you got?
I don't know. I'm about to play one more.
And that'll take like 20.
Probably about 30 minutes, 20, 30 minutes. 20, 30 minutes. Why are you feeling chatty, Kathy? I said, why are you feeling chatty, Kathy? We beat Mill. Haven't lost to that deck ever. I don't really like this. I don't really like this either. I guess we have turn two Fulminator. We'll give it a shot. Two rounds and we're already an hour 10 minutes into. We played a whole league in an hour 15 minutes. We're just playing against some slow ass players. Yeah. Ooh. All right. Seen a decent amount of Esper recently. I know Nikachu was doing a little blurb on how Esper was. It just feels like he's holding up a counter spell. Mm-hmm. That baits the counterspell. Doesn't look great for our hero, that's for sure. Tap, not that it really matters. $5 says this doesn't resolve. Alright, we are going to sideboard submit and then go grab some more water. Try and figure out what happened to our Bert's bees. Our lips are chapped AF. There it goes. Alrighty then. This stuff seems good. If they're boarding in Graveyard Hate, it's gonna be Rest in Peace, and Mass Vandal doesn't kill Rest in Peace. We should cut down on birds. Maybe I'll leave one of those in too. All right, I'm gonna go grab some more water. Why, yes, I would. Fuck, man. Just gonna mulligan into oblivion here. I have to do, it's fucking terrible. We got the combo in hand. Hopefully it is unadulterated. $5 says it won't be. We play that. Normally, we don't like to play Thunderkin out on turn two, but with this, if we do hit the land, we can Fulminator Mage his land, and then next turn we wouldn't be able to Soulstoke plus Thunderkin, so we have to cast it first, and we are punished for cutting our birds, I guess. We did up our lands to 22. We never hit like the exact amount of lands we want. We either are getting too many or we're getting too few. That's Moto for you, I guess. Cavern. We're still on Be Right Back, aren't we? That's fitting. Slowest land ever. Fate sealed and tucked any land. I think we're ready to pack it in, boys. Hands a little better, I'd say. Although it's still very, very slow. At least we have some removal. We'll pitch the Omnath. Although we could pitch the Soulstoke. As usual. That looks like a juicy Fulminator Mage target. Ariok champion getting bigger and bigger and bigger is going to be annoying. Do anything for the rest of the game because we're just gonna have a hard time beating this. God, I hate this deck. So consistent. This card is insane. Fulminator Mages. Yeah, that's good enough for me. Like, that is... just insane. Just insane. And this is why naming Bird with Cavernous Souls is so bad. Still two away from casting an Omnath. What a douche. Alright, let me get a surgical extraction, cause fuck you. Of course. I guess he drew that core spirit bullshit. God, I can't roll my eyes more at that fucking deck. It's so fucking nutty.
Big or small your business is, making your own ad on Spotify Ad Studio is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1. Let us know what you want your ad to say and pick out your music. We'll voice and produce it at no extra cost. 2. Reach Spotify listeners based on their interests, demographics, music tastes.
Sounds great. Mulligan's to 5, sounds like Tron. What do you need? Thank you. we're back. Sorry about that. Give me some lands, please. That's kind of like a land. But it doesn't cast either of our lightning skelementals, which is really what we were looking to do. It does let us get in for two, though. Here comes the ox. That's definitely going to get another creeping chill, so his blood guests are coming in with haste. Not good for me. Not good for me. Ouch, double creeping chill. Triple creeping show. Okay, dude. Yeah, congrats, buddy. Congrats. It seems great. Thank you. Games are going quick. Ooh, another one. Okay.
awesome? Lots of awesome things, all wrapped up in one awesome package.
Oops, didn't mean to put that with the nerd slow.
All sorts of awesome features. Unlimited skips, on-demand play, offline mode, extreme audio quality, every device, and uninterrupted music. Tap the banner to learn more.
Well, I think that's the list that we gotta go with. And we're battling for the 3-2. We definitely don't want to lose. Surgical, but I think we can do better. This ain't it either. Mulligans are killing us. He mulligans to 5-2 though. Sweet. All right, we need any land. Sweet. Told you. Sometimes those Zero Landers. They'll catch you there. Got the 20 turn clock now, baby. Watch out. We coming for you. Oh, we can't believe it. We can't believe it. Maybe that was the plan the whole time. Alright, I think I'm just gonna surgical this on his upkeep.
He's got two in his hand, too. Wow, we're bringing him all the way down. Wow. Wow, what a hit. He really doesn't have the land either. Wow. Do we just not take it out of his library then? So that maybe that's just one extra card that he could hit that's not a land? I think so. Yeah, you can keep the one in your library. I'd love for you to draw that. Well, there's the land. But now we got plays. That's gonna be way too slow. Oh, well, that could hit. Oh shit, there it goes. I'm instantly punished for leaving that stinkweed in this library. Still can beat this, though. We're gonna be hopefully gaining some life. And hopefully we can hit a fetch land. Fetch land would be perfect. Got a bunch of draws. Alright, we're gonna keep that. How much do we want? Do we need 4 or 5 mana? We want 3. I think we're fine with 3 mana. I mean 4 mana. And we nug him for 4. Alright, well, hopefully he can't beat us. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We just put the 8th card in. He has to not recur his blood ghast. He doesn't have any more dredgers. What do you have in his hand? He had a creeping chill. He discarded his blood ghast to a cathartic reunion. So he still has a cathartic reunion. He has a life in the loam that we know about. He has a stinkweed that we know about. All right. I still like our spot here. And we definitely kill him next turn. So he has to kill us this turn, and we're at 12. So I'm not sure he can do it. One creeping show and 2 Narc Amoebas. We should win now. We need to win. I'm almost done. I'm about to win this turn. Alright. We already have 2 lands. We need to hit 1 more land and nug them for 4. Evoke this just to, we're not getting any value out of it, but we are bringing it back with Thunderkin Awakener since we don't have anything else to bring back, and we're triggering twice. There's our nug for 4. There's there's graveyard insurance. We can't kill him, but we're definitely gonna kill him. Let's just add another attacker. We can't get another skill of Mentorn cast it because Hierarch doesn't tap for the manas.
Do I look cute?
You always look cute, hon. Zeus doesn't dictate to me, woman. GG. Yeah, it's GG. Alright, boys. I gotta dip out. Maybe I'll be on later tonight, but probably not. I think I'm getting turned.
Sure are!
Sure did.
Who's on?
Sure shorn.
Anybody on?
Now the
Grubscribers. Grub. Scriber. The scrub in Scrubscribers. Scrubscribe. Now! And I'd like to thank you, Scrubs. All of you new subscribers as well as you old subscribers. Scrubscribers. Stupid. And if you find yourself enjoying the content, consider Scrubscribing. We'd love to have you. I'm telling you. Should be subscribed, but you ain't. I don't know what you're waiting for. God, I am a huge fucking doucher.